Nobody
right,
cares
go
about your
ahead.
Thundercat shirt. Nigga, your ass down.
We good?
Welcome to A Few Good Minutes in the War Room on War Room Sports TV. I'm one of your hosts, Devin McMillan, and I'm here with my co-host, Jimmy Williams.
Rest in peace to Captain Lou Albano.
And B. Austin, the Thundercat.
Thunder, 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 Thundercats.
Now sit down. Yeah, we're here today to talk about your world champion, Miami Heat, and this 23-game winning streak that they got going. Of course, we know that the all-time streak was the 71-72 Lakers with 33 games in a row. Fellas, I want to know how impressed you are with the streak, and I want to know if you think the streak can be continued past 33 to be the longest winning streak in NBA history. B. Austin, what are your thoughts on the streak?
Yo, the streak is incredible. I'm impressed with, for me, it's about the discipline that these guys are showing to keep focused and come through at the end of games and just beat up. They're like the Monstars right now. But, you know, throughout the course of an 82-game season, it's not even that you're matched up with people that are better than you, but you just get tired and bored, and that leads to losses. So for them to hold it down this long, salute to the Heat. LeBron is playing out of his mind, as is D. Wade.
Yeah, I mean, I agree because, you know, we speak to a lot of people on a day-in and day-out basis who say, well, it's not that impressive because they haven't beaten a lot of playoff teams within that run. But like you alluded to, I think it's just difficult in an 82-game season to just get up night in and night out to
sustain that.
Yeah, and you're already the defending champ, so everybody's giving you their best shot. So no matter who you're playing, you know what I'm saying, the game ends up being a tough game. Think about it. Boston took them to the wire the other day. I mean,
last night, that's
Boston. So, you know, they always play tough no matter, you know, what position Boston's in.
Yo, my man,
Philly played them tough down to the wire. Orlando played them tough down to the wire. That's just everybody's best shot that you're going to get being the Miami Heat. What do you think, Jimmy?
Yo, it's very impressive to me. But before I even get into that, I'll just send a shout out to Jason Terry. I hope all is well. AKA Ralph Tresvant, because the boy looked like Ralph Tresvant. But no,
he's no longer with us.
It's definitely impressive, especially playing some of those teams who you know are beneath you. Teams like the Sixers, teams like Orlando. By the way, shout out to my man Spencer Halls, though. I can't diss Spencer Halls. But
Halls?
When you play teams like the Sixers, Orlando, and you know, teams that you know are beneath you, and you still find a way to win, because those are the games that you probably end up losing. Because how do you get for a game like that when you know that you could probably go out there and not give your best and still beat this team? So it's very impressive. Like you said, they're the champs,
and
as well as the streak. So they have a lot, you know. It's very impressive. And to all my Lakers fans out there, a lot of Lakers fans last night were telling me that we got to root for Boston to beat them so they won't come close to the streak. FOH, I don't care if they break the streak. I can never root for Boston to do anything. You know what I mean? Like, fuck Boston. That's all I got to say, y'all.
I was about to say half of y'all, but, you know, in our circle, our generation, our age group, y'all weren't even alive for the streak. So what are you holding on to?
Yeah.
Exactly. But my thing is, yo, as a Lakers fan, you can never root for the Celtics. I don't care if the streak's on the line or not, yo. You can never just root for the Celtics, man.
Personally, I'm rooting for the Charlotte Bobcats if they're on the schedule. I want them to.
Yeah, they're on the schedule like two or three games from now. Yeah. But speaking of going forward, because we only have a few good minutes today, 33, 34, I think it's possible. I'd probably say it's unlikely because – unlike back in the day, this streak is going to get so much scrutiny day in and day out because of the media-filled world that we live in. But I absolutely think it's possible just because, you know, those guys are just hard to beat. You know, even when they're not playing at their best, you know, they've come back in a lot of these games to take the wins. But even when they start playing some better teams, you know, I think it's possible, but I think it's a little bit unlikely. Closing thoughts, fellas?
Yeah, four Hall of Famers playing out of their mind right now with starter quality benchers, and they're playing the right way. It's going to be hard. Yo, shout out to my man Jeff Green. My man balled out, showed as much heart as anybody else, even with heart problems last night. Put up 43, gave a valiant effort. Jason Terry lost his life in the line of duty, and
All right, man. I'll go ahead, Jim, before we end it.
No, all I want to say is it's probable, considering the way they're playing, and specifically on the defensive end. Shane Battier is out there doing what he does best. You know, and it's crazy because D. Wade is like kind of getting overshadowed the way he's playing because LeBron is playing out of this universe. So I could see it happening. I definitely could see it happening. But all they're doing is putting more pressure on themselves. So we'll see how they maintain this.
As a basketball purist, man, no matter, you know, who you like and who you don't like, man, I root for things like this, especially when somebody gets this close. I don't want to see him, you know, not get it. But it's making a lot of people proud, including LeBron's dad. So we're going to end it there. This has been a few good minutes in the War Room. Make sure you check out our channel, warroomsportstv.com. Subscribe to the channel. Make sure you click the like button on the videos and leave some comments because we will comment back and get a dialogue started. So until next time, everybody, don't accept mediocrity and be steadfast in the war against ignorance.
See you chumps on top.
Wait, it's the War Room with five knights at the round table, five Philly guys diversified and educated.